Hello everyone, welcome to VLSI Point. I hope you have watched my last video. In that video, I have discussed the basic concept of FIFO. What is FIFO, why we need FIFO, and where FIFO is mostly used, then different types of FIFO. Actually, this FIFO is very important for exams and interview point of view. So if you have not watched that video, please watch and clear your concepts. In today's video, we are going to discuss few questions based on FIFO depth calculation. This topic is very important for your interview and for your exam. If you are watching my videos first time, then don't forget to subscribe my channel because here you will get all the materials and contents related to VLSI. So without any delay, let's get started today's video. So FIFO is mainly used to avoid overflow and underflow condition. So there could be two possible scenarios. First is writing frequency is more than reading frequency. Means your writing is faster than reading. So obviously there will be data loss. So there will be a overflow condition. Next scenario is your writing is slower than your reading. So there will be underflow scenario. FIFO size is mainly implies how much data you need to buffer. That is the meaning of FIFO size. One more thing you should notice in FIFO depth calculation, you should always consider the worst case. Now we can start with few examples. Your first question is write frequency is 100 MHz, read frequency is 50 MHz, burst size is 120. One more thing is given, there is no idle cycle between read and write. Now let me explain you one thing. Now in this figure you can see module X and module Y. Module X is operating at higher frequency and module Y is operating at lower frequency. Whenever you want to transmit the data from higher frequency to lower frequency, there you need to use FIFO. That means your writing is faster than reading. So obviously data will lose, and to avoid that data loss, you need to use FIFO there. So coming to the question, first, you need to calculate how much time is required to write one data item. That is nothing but 1 divided by the write frequency. So here it is 1 divided by 100 MHz, that is 10 nanoseconds. Then you have to calculate the total time to write a burst. Burst means what? The total data which you have to write, that is called the burst. So here total time is 120 into 10 nanoseconds, that is 1200 nanoseconds. Now you have to calculate time required to read one data item. That is nothing but 1 divided by read frequency. So here it is 1 divided by 50 MHz. So it is 20 nanosecond. Now you have to divide that total burst time with that read data time. So it is 1200 nanosecond divided by 20 nanosecond. So the answer is 60. So here the FIFO depth is nothing but the burst size minus 60. Burst size is what? 120. So 120 minus 60, final answer is 60. So here you need one FIFO with depth 60. So this is the entire calculation of FIFO depth. Here I am not giving you any particular formula because whenever examiner will make any small changes in the question, that time your formula will not be applicable. So here I am focusing to explain you the concept, how you can tackle these kind of question and what is the basic idea, how you can solve these things. I am focusing on that. So let me explain it one more time. First you have to calculate time required to write one data item, then you have to calculate total burst write time, then you have to calculate time required to read one data item, and finally divide the total time with that read data time. So whatever you will get, subtract that from the burst size, and finally you will get the depth of FIFO. Then you can calculate minimum burst to burst gap, that is nothing but the FIFO depth into read data time. Here it is 60 into 20 nanoseconds, so the answer is 1200 nanoseconds. So the minimum burst to burst gap is 1200 nanoseconds. So this is a very basic kind of question and I hope it is clear to you. Now we can start solving the next question. In this question, your write frequency is 200 MHz, your read frequency is 50 MHz and burst size is 120. One more thing is given, that is idle cycles. So now I'll explain what is idle cycle and how you can tackle such questions. So here it is given number of idle cycles between two successive write is 1 and number of idle cycles between two successive read is 2. So what is the meaning of idle cycle? Between two successive write, idle cycle is 1 and 1 cycle you need to perform the write operation. So total between two successive write, you need 2 cycles. Means write operation, then 1 idle cycle, then in next cycle you can perform the next write operation. Okay, similarly in case of read, there is total 2 idle cycles. So in 1 cycle you are performing the read operation, then 2 idle cycles, then in next cycle you can perform the another read operation. So in such questions, what you have to do, whenever you are calculating the time required to write one data item or time required to read one data item, you have to consider that total cycle required. So if you are calculating time required to write one data item, so it is nothing but 2 divided by write frequency. So it is 2 divided by 200 megahertz, that is nothing but 10 nanosecond. Now total burst time is 120 into 10 nanosecond, that is 1200 nanosecond. Similarly, time required to read one data item, that is nothing but 3 divided by read frequency. So it is 3 divided by 50 megahertz and the answer is 60 nanosecond. Now what you have to do, divide the total time by time required to read one data item. So it is 1200 nanosecond divided by 60 nanosecond and your answer is 20. So finally the FIFO depth is 120 minus 20, that is 100. So here you need a FIFO of depth 100. I hope you are trying to solve this question and not directly watching the solution. What you have to do after getting a question, pause the video, solve the question and then match your answers with my solution. Then you will get a perfect practice kind of thing. Coming to the third question, here write frequency is 200 megahertz, read frequency is 50 megahertz, burst size is 120. Here duty cycle is given. Duty cycle of write enable is 50% and duty cycle of read enable is 25%. Now 50% duty cycle means what? 1 by 2 and 25% duty cycle means what? 1 by 4. So here duty cycle means what? Cycles between two successive read or write operation. So here write enable has 50% duty cycle means the write enable is high for 50% time only and in remaining 50% time it is low. Similarly, the read enable is high for 25% of time and in remaining time it is low. So whenever you are trying to solve this question, while calculating the time required to write one data item, multiply with 2. And whenever you are trying to calculate the time required to read the one data item, multiply with 4. So here in the solution, you can see what we are doing, 2 into 1 divided by write frequency, that is 10 nanosecond. Then the total burst write time is 120 into 10, that is 1200 nanosecond. Again, data read time is 4 divided by read frequency, that is 4 divided by 50 megahertz, it is 80 nanosecond. And finally, what you have to do, divide the total burst time, that is 1200 nanosecond divided by 80 nanosecond. So it is 15. So here FIFO depth is 120 minus 15, that is nothing but 105. So here you need a FIFO of depth 105. I hope this question is clear to you and you got the concept of duty cycle and the idle cycle. What is the difference and how you have to tackle such questions? Now the next question is, write frequency is 40 megahertz, read frequency is 80 megahertz and burst size is 120. Now this question is very simple and try to solve this question by your own and then we'll discuss. I hope you have solved the question and you got the correct answer. So let me explain the solution. So in this question you can see the write frequency is less and the read frequency is more. That means the reading is faster than writing. That means there will be no data loss. So simply in this case, FIFO of depth 1 will be sufficient. No other calculation is required. So its answer is FIFO of depth 1. That's it. Coming to our fifth question, here the write frequency is 50 megahertz, read frequency is 50 megahertz, burst size is 120. Also, there is no idle cycle between read and write. So here in this question, read frequency and write frequency, both the frequency is equal. बट यू हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ द फेस. इफ फेस इज सेम एंड फ्रिक्वेंसी वैल्यू इज सेम देन देयर इज नो फीफो रिक्वायर्ड. बट इफ वैल्यू इज सेम बट फेस इज डिफरेंट इन दैट कंडीशन यू नीड टू डू द कंप्लीट कैलकुलेशन. सो फाइनली द आंसर इज फीफो इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. कमिंग टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ टूडेज वीडियो. राइट फ्रिक्वेंसी इज 40 MHz, रीड फ्रिक्वेंसी इज 40 MHz, बर्स्ट साइज इज 150. अगेन द ड्यूटी साइकिल ऑफ राइट इनेबल इज 1/2, ड्यूटी साइकिल ऑफ रीड इनेबल इज 1/4. नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल विल थिंक दैट रीड फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड राइट फ्रिक्वेंसी बोथ आर सेम, सो वी नीड नॉट टू डू एनी कैलकुलेशन, सिंपली वी टेल दैट नो फीफो इज रिक्वायर्ड. बट इट्स रॉन्ग. हियर रीड फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड राइट फ्रिक्वेंसी बोथ आर सेम बट यू हैव ड्यूटी साइकिल ऑल्सो. Write enable duty cycle is 50% and read enable duty cycle is 25%. So you need to do the calculation here. So try to solve and then we'll discuss. I hope you have solved the question. Now coming to the solution part. So this question is very similar to the older one which we have discussed based on the duty cycle. So here also what you have to do, 2 into 1 by write frequency, that is 50 nanosecond, then total burst write time is 150 into 50, that is 7500 nanosecond. Now you have to calculate time required to read one data item, that is nothing but 4 into 1 by read frequency, so it is 100 nanosecond. Finally what you have to do, 75 nanosecond divided by 100 nanosecond, so it is 75. So what is the FIFO depth? 150 minus 75, so it is 75. So here in this case, even though the frequency was same, but you need a FIFO of depth 75. This is the final answer. So we have discussed all the question of today's video and I hope you got the concept. If you have any doubt, you can tell me in the comment box or you can discuss in our Telegram group. If you have not joined that group till now, please join. Students are joining that group. They are discussing their problems. They are helping other students. So it's very productive to be a part of that group. If you like today's video and if you like my content, then don't forget to like my video. It's time to sign off. See you in the next video.